Pranab Bua Thakurta from EduTV. Today we have a very distinguished guest with us. She's an author, Miss Rana, Miss Aradhana Rana. She's the founder, principal, and director of the Icon Public School, Ahmednagar, Maharashtra. She's a soft skill trainer, a parenting coach, a motivational speaker, and a diehard educationist. She is also an author of several books on communication skills and spoken English. Her latest series, Master English, is to be published soon. So it is ready for booking pre-orders for the coming session. EduTV presents Ms. Aradhana Rana, the author of Master English. Ma'am, since we are talking about you, the author, please take us through your journey to becoming an author and how Master English was conceptualized.
Thank you, Pranav. Always a pleasure being on your show. And this especially, important because my series Master English is to be launched. And I would like to use this platform to get through to educationists. And, my main aim, Pranav, is about telling my story is that I really believe that if I can, anybody can. Because I never set out to be an author. I never set out to be what I am today. And gradually, as you know, life takes its twists and turns. And as one goes along, one finds new challenges in life. So in my life, I have been led with whatever I do, I just feel that I've got to do it well. So that has led to, I think, such diverse things that I've done in my life. So this is basically, anybody listening to it should draw inspiration from the fact that if I can, anybody can. You know, I am not trained to be an English writer at all. I was a science student and I did my master's in science. And life took turns where I was teaching English throughout my life because I was married to an army officer. And we just go to places and you just take on whatever you get. So teaching is one profession that army officers' wives generally take up. And as I got along, I developed a love for teaching. And as time flew by, I think I taught so much English that I just felt that I was in love with the language. Now, when we were posted in Delhi, I got an opportunity to work in a placement agency, which was also by default because I had no experience in it. But I really believe that one should take on, different things in life, their experiences. And I took on this placement agency job as just a varied experience. But that is where the seed was sown for me to be a writer. And, when I was running this agency, I realized that English was a language that really matters in India, at least. Right. For us, it's a status language. And of course, it's a language of the world. But in India, you are not considered educated till you know English. I'm not saying it's true. It's definitely not true. But this is the perception. So a lot of candidates were failing at interviews just because they didn't know English. So that is where this idea came up with that I should teach English to aspiring people, people who want to do something with their lives. And when I got an opportunity, I left my school job and opened a spoken English institute. So there I taught people from all walks of life. Now you see grammar, I had no base for grammar. I really, really struggled. I studied, I pored over books, and a number of hours I have spent in just getting to know and master this language is tremendous. So when I taught English to these people, and I was teaching English to even, jawans and army soldiers, so from doctors, engineers, teachers, just about anybody. So the worksheets that I gave them formed the basis for my first book. You know, I was teaching English at a management institute. Can you imagine MBAs? They're graduating from an MBA institute. And I had to teach them did, didn't, was, wasn't, have, has, you know, and the. It was that for a standard. So that led me to write my first book. And this journey has been very interesting, grueling, but very, very rewarding. So when I wrote my first book, one, I struggled with English. I was teaching English in schools. But to write a book, you need to be a master of grammar. So I did that. And then I was struggling with technology. I mean, when I wrote my first book with one finger typing, I wrote 400 pages. So that was the kind of hard work that went into it. And then gradually, you know, I started the school, the Icon Public School. And when I started the school, I realized that if I'm doing it for adults, I must do it for children. So I wrote a series called English Matters. That was a series of 8 books again, and it went into schools. So this was more school children based, a combination of activity book, workbook, grammar. Whereas all my other books are purely spoken English books, personality development, spoken English communication skills. So when I wrote for children, that was about 10 years ago. So those books have been in use in schools. But now with the NEP coming, they were getting a little redundant because there was a lot of written material in them and a very little of fun element. So that is why now I have written Master English, which is again a series of 8 books. It is, of course, it is graded from class 1 to 8. And there is a lot of activity-based, matter in them. Content is very activity-based. So this is a combination of a workbook, activity book, grammar book, and spoken English book. So this is the journey I went through. And it's been such a pleasurable, rewarding journey that I feel I must share it with people who are struggling to do something that they haven't done before.
Wonderful. Really get motivated by this. Thank you so much, ma'am. We'll just take a short break and come back again.
Master English is a series of 8 books for school-going children. It is an integrated package of a workbook, activity book, grammar book, and a spoken English guide.
Welcome after the break. And what is special about this series and how does it stand out in the plethora of grammar books in the market?
You see, I've been teaching English to school students for almost 30 years. And all throughout my career, I was a little disappointed with the kind of books we had. Because, most of the times I've taught in army schools. So the children coming there are soldiers' children, a few officers' children, but majority of them are soldiers' children. Now, when we have books with these publications, which are foreign publications, there is nothing that the children relate to in these books. I remember I was teaching class 5 and the course book was from a foreign publication. And I went to the chairman and I said, why do we have these books? These children who come from villages or small towns, they have never heard of pancakes and muffins for breakfast. Right. So here the characters in the book are eating pancakes and muffins for breakfast. They can't relate to it. Their names. There was a name I still remember, Huayt, which even I couldn't pronounce. You know, I really didn't know how to pronounce that word. Why would a class 5 child relate to another small child in the book called Huayt? Why can't it be a common Indian name? The scenarios were all foreign. The language was so difficult. And ultimately, they were not learning anything. I am not, in favor of teaching grammar as pure grammar. So again, if we have a grammar book, something like Wren and Martin, which all of us have studied, you see, it's grammar has been a very boring subject. because it doesn't relate to our real life. So this series of books, one, is very usage friendly. Everything in the book is usage. So whether it is spoken English or the grammar part of it, activity, there's a lot of vocabulary, everything relates to the child. So that is why I feel that this book is very different from anything in the market. I have, I've seen a lot of books now as principal. I see many more books. There are people coming to me to sell books. So I evaluate, books. And when I see them, I feel there is no comprehensive package that gives you, everything. So you have to have 3-4 books. And when you have 3-4 books, one, the bag becomes heavy. Secondly, psychologically, the children feel they have to study 4 books. So this book with a literature reader prescribed by the board is a package in itself. Actually, it could do without a literature reader also, but a lot of comprehension, reading ability comes from literature reader. So any one literature reader if a child has to be treated just for comprehension and reading, not to be learned and, a question answer, fill in the blanks, those kind of things, no, because this book has it all. So that is how it is different from other books in the market.
Wonderful. That's a pretty good thing. Aradhana, what is the focus of this series?
The focus of this series is totally on making the child conversant with usage English. That is why I've only written class 1 to 8. You see, class 1 book is basic fun book where the child, has a little foundation of usage sentences and grammar. Now, as you graduate from class 1 to 7, the chapters remain the same, only the level of difficulty increases. Like, I'll tell you an example. In class 1, we do teach nouns. But nouns, they're just taught as naming words, and they're common and proper nouns so that the child knows the capital letter has to be put, a full stop has to be put. In class 2, we introduce the singular, plural, these kind of things. And in class 3, we introduce concrete and abstract nouns. So in class 4, we go a step further. So the names of the chapters remain the same, but the level of difficulty increases. So it's a very graded series. Secondly, it's not a book to be thrown away after a class.
Right.
I mean, once you start with the book, you keep the whole series of 8 books. It will serve you, even in later years. So it's not the just throwaway book. Now, till class 7, the child, if the child has gone through the whole series, by class 7, the child is very conversant with the grammatically correct sentences. In class 8, there is no grammar. In class 8, it starts with the board pattern, which is a lot of comprehension. So the class 8 book is designed to have certain themes. So on those themes, their comprehensions, their MCQs, and a lot of vocabulary development, creative writing skills. So this is the first step towards the board examinations. So that is how it's graded. So the focus is totally on usage English. A lot of repetition. The USP of the book is there are a lot of oral exercises. And there is an audio guide which is there for every book. So the whole book is taught on the audio guide and it is practiced. So even teachers who are not conversant with pronunciation or English words, they play the audio guide and the child learns the right pronunciation, learns the right vocabulary. So it can go even to, rural schools or B grade, C grade city schools where the teachers are not very conversant with English. So that is a USP of the book.
Oh, great. Ma'am, we'll just again take a short break and come back again. Aradhana, I believe this series is designed, edited, and being published by you. Why did you take up this all in one role. Now, how you managed it?
Now, again, Pranav, I really believe that whatever you teach yourself, I think that you learn best because one, you're interested. Secondly, you discover a lot of things. Like I told you, I was a computer illiterate when I wrote the first book. After that, I learned, you know, I learned the Word file first. Then when I went to publish my book or print my book, I didn't know that you needed a publisher. So I went to a normal printer to print my book. And he told me, he says, you don't print books like this. It's not on a Word file. It should be on PageMaker or Corel. Okay. So then I learned PageMaker. So I did the book myself. Now, after that, I've published about 20 books. Now, when I see each cover, actually, I have designed. I've sat with the publisher, designed it because somehow I've never been satisfied with the run-of-the-mill covers that they give you. So since I designed each book myself, the credit went to the publisher, but I did all the work in his office. So I thought, why not do it myself? I mean, now I know the technique. One. Then secondly, as far as the layout and formatting is concerned, over a period, I learned that my book is the most important thing for me. The way I will love it, nobody else can. They do it, you know, as a professional. I do it with my heart. So I know exactly what I want the reader to read in bold, in bold font, in, you know, normal font, in italics. So those kind of things, you know, monitoring is as difficult, you know, if you don't trust the publisher. So overall, though, I've had very good publishers. I mean, I wouldn't say that they were not good, but I've labored a lot with them. And since I've learned from them, I thought I'll do it myself. Now, whereas publishing is concerned, you know, I felt that publishers do not market your book well. I'm a principal of a school and I have booksellers coming to me. The way they leave their books on my table without any regard of the kind of work the author has put in, it just puts me off because being an author, this is my life's work. Nobody else can promote it more than I can. So, you know, I don't believe in leaving my books on anybody's table. So what I've done is this time, I have put my books on a flip book. And I am just sending it out to principals and educationists who care. And then they can see the book on flip book and order it from me. The rest is then just printing. That is why I'm asking for pre-orders. I mean, the whole book you can see on the flip book. There's nothing that you require physically on the table. And it's much easier. I feel there's so much technology in our life. Why shouldn't we make use of it? Why are we doing the same things of, you know, sending marketing executives to schools? So this is paper saving. This is a lot of books go waste. I mean, I feel so sorry because I write books. For each bit of paper that goes waste, I feel sorry. So now with this kind of thing, I may not be able to reach as much as a good publisher would. But I'm sure by word of mouth, in a few years, the books will travel and will do well. So since I have that confidence, I'm doing it myself.
Good. Great. Aradhana, how it is priced, ma'am?
The class 1 to 3 is priced at 225 per copy and 4 to 8 is 250 per copy. But since there are no middlemen involved, so I can offer a lot of discounts to schools because also, you know, let me tell you, Pranav, I believe this is going to be my last series. You know, I am writing books takes a lot out of you as far as health is concerned. So I don't think I'll be writing another English book. I'm thinking of writing a fiction, but that's going to be very relaxed. So since it's my, you know, last signature series, I have decided that all proceeds from this book will go towards a scholarship scheme for children who cannot afford good education. So I am not looking at money making from this book. I'm looking for people to read it, people to appreciate it. And all my books have been appreciated by people. They haven't had that great a reach that I can become a Harry Potter. But, you know, otherwise, whoever's seen it has really appreciated them. And let me share one thing with you. I get many awards and accolades, but the best reward that I've got is for my first book that I typed with my single finger. I got a call from somebody totally unknown from Calcutta, and he found my number. He rang me up and he says, "Madam, I saw your book at the public library and I went through it and I've been through your book word by word. And let me compliment you, I could not find a single mistake." So that was my crowning glory, you know. I really thought that that was the best compliment I ever got. So if I've labored so much on it, I feel that it will do well eventually.
We are sure, ma'am. Ma'am, how do you plan to market it? As you said, you want to tell about the book to the school owners or principals or English teachers.
One, friends like you, hopefully they should have faith. Then secondly, I am in touch with a lot of principals, and I really am not in such a hurry because this is the first year. So I firmly believe that wherever the books go, they will spread by word of mouth. But like I told you, otherwise I am using technology. So whatever platform I get, I am doing a digital marketing course also these days, especially to learn how to market, because that's one area I've never worked in. So let's see how it goes. And I'm sure I'll learn enough to do it. You know, in fact, this is the first time I have designed my own website also. So I've designed it totally with the help of YouTube videos, and I'm pretty thrilled about it. So I'll learn that also, and gradually digital marketing should help.
Oh, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Aradhana, what makes this series special to you as an author?
Like I said, Pranav, I believe this is going to be my last series. So that is why it makes it very, very special. I'm at an age where I can't afford to write much more, after this, because my health does suffer. So since it's going to be my last, series, I put in my heart and soul into it. And since it's totally my baby, I've designed the cover, I've designed the layout, the matter and the audios, so everything. So that is why, I mean, this is like really a baby to me.
Great, great, great. Ma'am, I'm sure your book will do very well. And after listening to your Edu TV, a lot of people will get motivated and they'll surely think, if Aradhana can wear so many hats, why can't they? Thank you so much, Aradhana. I wish you all the best for your books. And I congratulate all the kids also. They will get, I think you pointed a very right thing, that why they talk about muffins and all with the students of Jawan or our government schools. Things are different there, different here. I'm really impressed with your idea. It is, as our Prime Minister also says, think global and act as local. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Pranav. Thank you very much.